Let's talk about how to grow vinegar eels. If you're looking for a live fish food that's easy to culture, doesn't stink, and lasts a long time with no maintenance, then vinegar eels will be right down your alley. Vinegar eels are not really eels, but a type of harmless nematode, and they're really tiny, even smaller than microworms. If your baby fish fry are too small to eat microworms, then vinegar eels might be just the thing. To my knowledge, the only thing smaller would be infusoria, and don't get me started on that topic. One advantage of feeding vinegar eels is that they swim and stay suspended in the water column where fish and fry can find them and eat them. In contrast, microworms sink rapidly and can get lost in the substrate. I bought a 500 milliliter culture from a local hobbyist for $5. I thoroughly cleaned 3 clear glass bottles with tall, skinny necks. Yeah, I've got a sweet tooth, so I go through a lot of butter ripple schnapps. You can culture vinegar eels in any sort of container, but a bottle like this will make harvesting much easier. I divided the culture equally between the 3 bottles. Then I cut up 1 slice of fresh apple for each bottle. The precise amount isn't important. Next, I added enough dechlorinated water to fill each bottle halfway. Then I added apple cider vinegar to bring the level up to the shoulder of the bottle. That's it. I covered each bottle with a piece of paper towel, fastened it with a rubber band, and put them in the basement. Here's what the culture looked like 1 month later. I easily could have started harvesting at this point. Here's a view at 2 months, and here's what they looked like at 3 months. One of my sources states that a culture of vinegar eels can last over 6 months with no additional food or upkeep. That's pretty impressive. A fellow hobbyist said he had a culture in his basement that was 2 years old and still viable. You can't beat that for being hassle-free. Here's how to harvest vinegar eels. I use the top-off and siphon method, hence the need for a tall-necked bottle. Take a piece of fine filter floss, tie a string around it, and push it down just to the bottom of the bottle's neck. Fill the neck above the floss with dechlorinated water. Hold the string so the floss doesn't fall down into the bottle. The water will stay above the vinegar solution. Wait 20 to 30 minutes. The eels will swim up through the floss in search of oxygen. Then you just need to suck up some eels with an eyedropper or syringe and feed them to your fish. I haven't kept vinegar eels long enough to know how long a single culture will last. I start 3 new cultures every month just because I'm obsessive and I want to know I'll have them available if I need them to feed fish fry or to sell them locally. Thanks for watching, and let me know how you grow and harvest vinegar eels.